This is a fictional mindbender. Thomas Dubois is portrayed a lot of times as a pitiful character in the Boondocks. Not because he's a black man in a suburban setting, but because he's a black man in a suburban setting and is clueless or at best a weak person. I think there's more to him than that, however. Throughout the series, Tom is not just a black man living in the burbs, but a successful black man living in the burbs. Having a career as a lawyer and being an active part of his community. I'm not sure how he grew up, but I believe that on an intellectual level, he is aware of racism and the struggle that black people have, but that he lacks the experience of actually dealing with it, or at the very least, the urban experience. And back in the 90s and the 2000s, this was a thing. There was a perception that being black automatically equaled being ghetto and all it stereotypically entailed. And if you did encounter a black person who was raised in the burbs, then it was treated like an abnormality. And the character epitomizes this view, I believe. Well-dressed, kind, well-educated, but weak-willed. That he struggles to stick up for himself when bullied or pushed around by someone larger than himself, or even in his marriage for that matter, are signs of that. Of course, any Boondock fans know that this is perfectly put on display in the episode where Tom gets possessed by the ghost of Stinkmeaner. In many ways, it's the perfect pairing because more than anyone else, Stinkmeaner and Tom are mirror opposites of each other. And it's no small coincidence either that the voice actor for both characters was the same guy. And you have to know he had fun doing that. Stinkmeaner is rude, will fight you before you drop the dime, and is loud as fuck. And it's not even worth calling him a racist because Stinkmeaner hates everybody, and has zero problem letting the public know about that as well. A direct contrast to Tom Dubois and his lifestyle. But more than that, it's also perfect in a way because I think Tom does have that inner Stinkmeaner in him. He has a lot of repressed anger issues and insecurities that he was reluctant to deal with. Yet, he's also the most physically fit out of all the Boondock characters. So, in many ways, Stinkmeaner Dubois, if you will, is Tom let off the leash, if he didn't hold back his inner demons and negative attributes. And he does let that dog out without Stinkmeaner's influence from time to time later on. And yeah, that marriage to his wife Sarah was a giant bullseye for anyone wanting to undermine him. This was also put on display hilariously by a ghettoized Ben Franklin looking lawyer who, during a trial against R. Kelly that Tom was prosecuting, used that as a final argument to cement his defense for R. Kelly and therefore got the victory against Tom. Again, this was, and I think still is among some, a major sore point that black men look to white women as sexual partners or wives over other black women. I think there's more diverse interactions now among millennials and zoomers that is not as much as a huge issue as it was back then, but it can still be a thing. If incensed enough, many black characters in the show do see Tom as being a Uncle Tom, hence the character name I believe. Someone who sold out to the white American culture in every single way. But that same episode also shows something I think people miss out on, in that it shows Tom and his wife are aware of that trigger, and are not necessarily taken surprise by it, but are still frustrated by it. It's also implied that his sex life with Sarah isn't exactly the greatest. Sarah Dubois is a great character as well, but I'll leave the details of that for another time. Suffice it to say though, it's more than implied that she does have a preference when it comes to men that she finds attractive, and is quite excited vocalizing that if you ask her. Moreover, she's quite pleased by a more aggressive and possessed Tom if he's not normally like that, then will gladly reciprocate the favor. I think her sex-positive attitude makes Tom insecure if it's not directed at him, which can imply a fear of her walking out on him for someone better. And I think this is actually true. And this is also a testament to his private lack of faith in her devotion as well. Tom, on all levels, tries as much as possible to avoid direct conflict, and no one brings this out more than Sarah Dubois. Regardless of his flaws, though, Tom is not a sellout, say, like Uncle Ruckus. He's not in denial of his race. Rather, though, he represents another facet of black culture in America, that it is not, in fact, one monolithical type idea or stereotype, and that despite Huey's view of all black people being under the thumb of the man, there are also those who thrive and do quite well for themselves. Also too, though, Tom Dubois is an optimist. He is someone who is willing to believe the best in people despite having a career where he often encounters the worst, and despite of Huey's cynicism, Riley's devotion to gangster culture, Granddad's apathy, and Ruckus's self-hatred / racism, he never gives up on that hope. And that takes an inner strength to do that against all odds. And as well, I think this is why Sarah remains married to him as well, that she is attracted to Tom's sense of optimism and hope, and that he doesn't give up on that. Tom Dubois isn't quite the contradiction like many other Boondocks characters are, but there are levels to him and his worldview, if you pay attention enough. But if you happen to disagree with that, or agree with that, or add anything else to that, let me know in the comments below. And this is the Fictional Mindbender. You guys have a good day.